Hello students, now we study about the evolution and growth of commerce, how the commerce developed. Here it passed a different stages. The different stages are the important stages of the evolution of the commerce, or hunting kind, fishing stage, pastoral stage, agricultural stage, handicraft change stage, barter exchange stage, now money economy stage, town economy stage, and the international trade stage. Here these are the important stages of the evolution and growth of commerce. In the first stage, that is hunting and fishing stage, it was the earliest stage of the human civilization. It is the earliest stage of the human civilization. During this stage, man was a wanderer. He migrated from one place to another place in search of the food. In search of food, he migrated from a place to place, and he moved in a group from one place to another place in search of food. They hunted animal for food. Fishing was also carried out by the man, and they gathered fruits, nuts for food. They lived in caves or hollows of the trees. They covered their bodies with the leaves of the trees or skins of animals to protect their bodies from the sun, wind and rain. So they protected their body with the bark of the trees. Some people, they used the bark of the trees, and some are used the leaves of the trees, and some people, they used the skins of animals. Like, they protected their bodies from sun, rain and wind. And no economic activity existed during this stage. No any economic activities existed during the early stage. That is hunting and the fishing stage. It is not hunting stage. It is hunting and the fishing stage. That time no any economic activities take place during this stage. Now the second, the pastoral stage. Second one is the pastoral stage. The first one is the hunting. Hunting and fishing stage. Here the important occupation of the people during this stage was only hunting and fishing are the two important occupations of the people, and during this stage no economic activity existed. Now the second, pastoral stage. During this stage, people learned domestication of animals. During the pastoral stage, people learned about the domestication of some animals. In the beginning, they reared cattle, sheep and goats, and these animals provided food to eat and skins to cover their bodies. All these animals, you know, sheep, then goat and the cattle, they provided food as well as food to eat and skin to cover their bodies. They moved from one place to another place in search of the grasslands. In search of the grasslands, they moved from one place to another place along with their cattle in search of the grassland and the water. Here, though man had reached some higher level in the development of in the development and commerce did not existed. Man has developed to some extent, but no economic activity existed during the pastoral stage also. But the man reached some higher level in development, but no economic activity existed even during the pastoral stage. They only learned about the domestication of animals. So they reared some animals like the goat, sheep, cows, etc. Now the third stage was the agricultural stage. After some years of the pastoral stage, people learned the art of cultivating the crops. You know, first of all, they domesticated the animals like the cow, buffalo, sheep, goat, ox, etc. And afterwards, they learned the art of growing some crops. They started living at a fixed place. They started a settled life. They began to live in one particular geographical area. They began to live in groups and commercial activities. Slowly the commercial activities started during the agricultural stage. And you know, the villages, communities came into the existence, because when they began to live in one particular geographical areas, in a fixed areas, so the villages and the communities came into existence, and simple form of division of labor was started. Simple form of division of labor was started only during the agricultural stage. Now the fourth, that is handicrafts stage. Agriculturist wanted some tools or implements. They wanted houses to live. They want houses to live, because they began to live in one, they began to lead a settled life. So they wanted houses to live. To fulfill these requirements, some people engaged themselves in making the tools and also construction of houses. So some people engaged themselves in the preparation or making the tools which are required for the agriculture, and some people are engaged in the construction of houses. They are called as the craftsmen. These people were called as a craftsmen, who are engaged in the construction of houses, who are engaged in making the tools and equipments. They are called as the craftsmen, you know, the carpenters, goldsmiths. They are called as gradually a body of these professional craftsmen, such as the carpenters, blacksmiths, weavers, builders, came into existence. So they made one group or the union. Such type of craftsmen or the professional craftsmen came into existence. So the carpenters, they have their own guild. They formed their own association. Then the blacksmiths, weavers, builders, and they carried on the production of goods in their house and supplied to the agriculture. You know, the blacksmith, they produced the tools and equipments in their own house, and these goods, these tools and agricultural implements were supplied to the farmers. And in return, the agriculturist provided them with their requirements. In return of their services, because the craftsmen, they supply the needs of the agriculturist, and in return agriculturist, they provided them with their requirements like the food crops, you know, the food grains and other requirements. Now the barter exchange system came into existence. So it led to the system of the barter exchange system because the craftsmen supplied tools and equipments to the agriculturist, and agriculturist they exchanged or they provided food grains to the craftsmen. Like this, the barter system of exchange came into existence during the handicraft stage. Now the barter system stage, here the division of labor enabled quick production of goods. The goods produced were directly exchanged. The goods which were produced were directly exchanged. The direct exchange of goods for goods or other things is called as barter system of exchange. You know, the barter system of exchange means the direct exchange of goods for goods or things, other things, is called as barter exchange system. But here some problem arise in the barter exchange system. The important problems of the barter system are the lack of double coincidence of wants. Lack of double coincidence of wants. If two parties exchange goods with each other, if two parties A and B, two parties exchange goods each other, we call it as a coincidence of wants. But such double coincidence of wants was very rarely found. For example, A has a paddy and want wheat. A has a paddy, but what he wants? He wants wheat. And B has wheat, but his want is jowar. And B is not prepared to take paddy. You know, the B has a sufficient quantity of wheat, but he did not want the jowar. He did not want the paddy because A has an abundant quantity of paddy, and B, he has abundant quantity of the jowar. But the want of the B, want of second party, is that is wheat. But wheat is not available in the first party. So that is a lack of double coincidence of wants and lack of common measure of value. It was very difficult to decide the quantity of one commodity to another. Decide the quantity of one commodity to another commodity. For example, for one cow, how many sheep? Or for one measure of wheat, how many measure of jowar, etc. It was the difficulty to divide. So the difficulty of division of a commodity or a thing was one of the important problem of the barter exchange. Now the difficulty of subdivision. There is a difficulty of subdivision. We cannot divide the cow. We cannot divide the cow. We cannot divide the things. So there is a difficulty of subdivision. It was difficult to divide some animals or the things. We cannot divide the animals or the things. Now difficulty to store the goods or the transportation. And you know, that time there was no development of transport and communication. So the difficulty store, you know, the warehouses. That time there were no warehouses or the godowns. So there was a difficulty of storage of goods and transportation of goods. The movement of goods from place to place was very difficult. And they cannot store the goods in a particular place because there were no warehouses or the godowns. These are the problems arise during the barter system of exchange. Now the money economy stage, to overcome the difficulties of barter exchange system, Many medium of exchange were used. For example, skins of animals, cowrie shells, etc. were introduced. Later, the metals were used as a medium of exchange. Metals were used as a medium of exchange. The metals were brought into a particular shape and weight and used as a medium of exchange. You know, the metals were made or used, brought into a particular shape and size, and they were used as a medium of exchange. Afterwards, copper, silver, gold coins came into existence. Here also some difficulties experienced, mainly transportation. You know, when they introduced the metal coins, you know, the copper, silver and gold coins, that time our difficulties arise. The difficulties were experienced, that is the transportation difficulties, because the copper coins, you know, if there are 1 lakh copper coins, it is very difficult to supply or transport the rupees 1 lakh copper coins from place to place. So that the transportation difficulties arise. And afterwards, paper money came into be used. Paper money is a token money which is generally comprised of the bank money. Currency notes or the paper money came into existence. It comprises of bank notes issued by the Central Bank of India, Central Bank of our country, you know, Reserve Bank of India. It has the authority to mint or issue the currency notes or the paper money. It has full support of the government. Nowadays, bank money is in the form of check, draft, bills, credit cards, debit cards, etc. are in practice. They are playing a very important role. Now the town economic stage, introduction of bank money as a medium of exchange resulted in the fast growth of commerce. When the bank money was introduced, there is a fast growth of trade and commerce. People began to produce more goods. Producers started meeting at a fixed place at a periodical intervals. People began to assemble in a one fixed place, you know, in a bazaars, and they began to sell their commodities. They were called as the local markets, you know, local markets, Sunday markets, Tuesday markets, Monday, like this. Periodically they assemble in one particular place along with their products. These local markets developed into towns and centers of supply goods. These local markets, gradually they developed into the towns and the centers to supply the goods and services. The merchants came into existence. So economic activities began. Economic activities started. They began to supply. They began to exchange their goods and services. And invited the craftsmen to particular place, collected raw materials and started producing the finished goods and supplied to the consumers. During this stage, the commerce developed largely and the market extended far and wide. So during the town economy stage, the markets extended far and wide. So the economic activities started at a faster rate. Now the eighth one is international trade stage. International trade stage, you know, geographical discoveries took place during the 15th and 16th centuries. You know, Columbus, who discovered America, Vasco da Gama discovered sea route to India, and Magellan, a Portuguese navigator, with the help of the king of Spain, set his sail to circumnavigate the world. And he crossed the southern cape of South America and reached the Pacific Ocean. He reached Philippine Island and was killed by the locals. When Magellan reached Philippines Islands, there he was killed by the local people of the Philippines. But his ship Victoria returned to Spain after 3 years. This was the first ship which sailed around the world. So the ship Victoria, it was the first ship which sailed around the world. So we say that Magellan was the first whose ship sailed around the world. Here the industrial revolution which took place in England and geographical discoveries helped for a large-scale production of goods, and not only for the local market but also for the other countries. So these two reasons, industrial revolution and the geographical discoveries, they helped for the large-scale production of goods and services, not only for the local market. They not only produced the goods only for the local market but also for the international market, for the other countries. Now the standardization goods were produced with the help of the machines. You know, the goods which were produced are very superior because they are produced by using the modern machines, modern tools and machines. So the superior quality goods were produced, standard goods were produced with the help of the modern technical devices, and revolution in transportation, communication helped for the expansion of the market. Here, when the transport and communication developed, it led to the development of the markets, expansion of the markets, because without transport, without communication, there is no expansion of the market. So when there is expansion of the transport and communication took place, it leads to the expansion of the market. The production of goods was carried out not only for the national market but also for the international market. When there was a large scale production, when the production was more, it is not only used for the national market, it is also used for the international market. So these are the 8 stages of the evolution of trade and commerce. The first stage, hunting and fishing stage. The second, pastoral stage. Third, agricultural stage. Handicraft stage. Fifth, barter exchange stage. Money economy stage. Town economy stage. And international trade stage. These are the different stages. By these stages, the trade and commerce developed.